Welcome back to PST Channel. In this Wuthering Waves quick and sweet guide, we will explain how to calculate damage in the game and clarify its confusing terms. First, we talk about base attack. The base attack of most character is calculated from ATK value. So base attack is simply just your ATK. However, some character might use different values such as HP. So, you just have to check it from the skill detail to learn about this first. Skill modifier. After that, you also see the modifier number from it. It tells you how much multiplier it does add directly into your base attack stat. At this point, you will notice that many character sequence label about adding multiplier increase. So many people misunderstand by the wording increase that it referred to additive, but actually, this value is actual multiply. For example, Yinlin Forte Circuit Judgment Strike DMG multiplier increased by 55%. Means that it does 1.55x of what it does before. From 62.75% per hit to 62.75*1.55=97.26%. Now, in contrast, many people don't believe it at first. But GNS6 upgrade his multiplier of his Dragon Stomp Liberation for 240%. People were thinking if it had only just add 240% to the original 500% to make it 740%. But no. Actually, it power up more than 3 times for it to be 104.59 by 2 plus 313.78% *3.40=1778%. Which is why you see some whales do over 100k number first with GN during early period of the game. This skill just doesn't do big number without S6. However, this skill isn't GN main source for DPS either, so it is fine. So to sum up, we just learned the most basic. Skill base damage is equal to base attack multiplied by skill modifier. Next, there are 3 type of additional damage in this game. The easy to find damage bonus type and the usual outro damage amplified type. Then lastly, the notable critical damage. So we altered the formula to damage is equal to skill base damage multiply DMG bonus multiply DMG amplified multiply critical damage. The damage bonus combine everything that mentioned damage bonus. Be it elemental damage bonus, skill damage bonus, liberation damage bonus, or even basic attack damage bonus. If the condition required is met, then you put them together into one additive number. In this case, you can see that elemental damage bonus is better than specific skill damage bonus, because elemental ones work for any kind of attack, it doesn't specific as skill, liberation, or heavy attacks. Then the game is trying to confuse you with another word damage deals. You see this often in weapon description or sequence description. Please understand that it is the same thing as damage bonus. For example, my Yinlin S5 has low rating star from my video, because this one only give damage bonus for 100% on her liberation. This value has diluted so much already, and 100% only shown this much increase from what I tested. Then we have the partnership slash Nakama power-up zone with damage amplified. This value is usually found from allies outro buff, in which, the most popular and the most universal one is from Varina 15% all DMG amplifier. And then after that we have niche-specific buffs such as Sanwa's basic ATK buff, Mortify's heavy ATK buff, and Tachi's skill buff. Those are real amplify number as they are not diminished by other stuffs. So you can see a huge impact here. And lastly, I think we have this crit damage number. I think everyone already understand this value, so I won't explain it much. Basically, if you have enough luck to land a crit, then your damage is multiplied by crit damage. So just multiply this number at the end, and that's it. So we have finished our damage formula talk. It is so simply right? You just get the base skill damage first, then you multiply it with 3 things. That's it! However, actually there is also enemy defend and resistance value at work here too. But it is not something you have to care about as of now. Because enemy defense in this game is a fixed value on each world level. It also same to most anime-based game too that they mostly don't gonna alter this value after. Therefore, the only thing that you have to care about defend is the defend ignore. This value calculation is such simply that you just add them into another multiplier directly separate from anything you mentioned before. For instance, Chun-Li, the new character, will have defend ignore value of 15% on her attack. So, this make damage of those attacks are all multiple by 1.15. Simply as that. Then enemy resistance, which is the last part for this video. I will says that so far most enemy only have resistant to their same element. Such as Monkey, will resist arrow element. Memphis will resist lightning element. That is all you need to know for now so that you won't try to use same element character attacking them, because it will causes you much more time. In summary, what can we get from learning this calculation? Well, you know that 1.2 times 1.2 is equal to 1.44, which is higher than 1.4 times 1.0 is equal to 1.40, right? So, when you choose what stat to increase, you will want to try to balance out this value out to achieve the best result. In this game, you can try to balance ATK, DMG bonus, and crit DMG, because you can't change anything on DMG amplifier and def ignore. You also learn DMG multiplier so you understand how effective are from each sequence and don't get lie with damage deals. And lastly, the golden ratio for crit rate is usually 1 to 2 of the amount of crit damage gain. And that's it! See? It is much easier to understand, right? Anyway, I hope you enjoy and learn something from this. Give like and subscribe to let me know if you like this quick and sweep summary style I do for Wuthering Waves content. Let's have fun and enjoy Wuthering Waves together. My followers, I love you all. See you next time.